Someone out there? Hello? What a swan, eh? Never mind. Francis, the radar's acting up again. You were supposed to tune up this piece of junk years ago. Sector B, do you read me? I'm picking up your distress signal in the outer zone. It looks like you're somewhere around Sector E. Hey, Francis, come here. Yes, it's urgent. Leave that interferometer alone for a second. Something is out there. Hey, we got a live one. Hey, do you copy? Hello? Hello? Is this thing working?
They don't have a transmitter. We won't hear a thing back.
Huh. But if they're stranded, could they, they're from outside? They're a breacher? Hey, how did you get through the barrier wall? No one's gotten into the zone in ages and lived to tell about it.
And if we don't get them to safety, this one won't either.
That's a good point. Hey, you're in serious danger. The instability's closing in, and it's gonna scramble you quicker than beef in a blender. Your closest shelter is a few miles east. Get there however you can, and be quick about it. Spectrometer. I've seen that waveform before, but where? No kidding. Could it be? A remnant?
That can't be. There hasn't been one in decades.
Look at that spectral fingerprint and tell me that doesn't match the remnants exactly.
No. What we should be looking at is how fast this creature seems to be moving.
Huh. You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say they're going about the speed of a... No way. Do not tell me. They found a remnant, and it's a car this time? Holy cripes! No one's had working wheels in here for ages. Boy, I'd kill to know how a combustion engine's still chugging away out there.
Okay, let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, the breacher needs to get to safety. Then we can look into whether that car is a remnant or not.
In my heart of hearts, I already know. They're back, baby. Find that shelter, go on and let yourself in. Albie ain't gonna like you poking around in there, but better to face a bad side than let the zone eat you alive.
over there. Oh, the shop. God, it's been breached. You've got 5 seconds to get the hell out of my... Ow! My head. It's an emergency broadcast.
Hello, attention. This message is for Dr. Ophelia Turner. We sent a breacher to your garage on official zone business. Now, we have it on very good authority that this person is in possession of a remnant, which has taken the form of a car, and, well,
check off the remnant thing. She's not gonna care.
Right, like I said, super official zone business. Protocol, demands that you keep them alive until we can get them to safety. Now, if you do not comply, I will occupy this broadcast channel with a recitation of the entire collection of poems I've personally written. That's 10 years and 17 volumes and...
Tell her that voice, because it's like a nail gun to the skull. So, another breacher, huh? How do you outsiders not understand? And oh, I didn't build that 300-meter wall out there for fun. Unless you're one of the unfortunates who got zapped through. Wait, I just remembered. I don't give a damn why or how you got here. You're trespassing, and I'd kindly like you to get the hell out of my zone.
God, unfortunately. Barrier wall is as fortified against breachers trying to get in as it is against anyone or anything trying to leave. We have to find you a way out. So you might as well start by fixing up that car. Just don't break anything in my shop with those soft hands of yours.
Thank you.
There's a little prototype of mine in the garage. This beauty won't just be your tour guide. It's your North Star and the only way back to safety. Heck, you should consider it the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit if you plan on staying alive. That's how important this thing will be to you. Yes, that's my very own invention. I'll tell you more about it if you live long enough to use it. Take a look at the projector against the wall. This is the zone. Within these borders, all matter has lost the ability to hold a constant physical state. What that means is the shape, size, and makeup of just about everything constantly changes. A mile of grass can turn into 10 miles of swamp in the blink of an eye, and it does. Constantly. It's caused by something we call instability. We're completely surrounded by it, and once you've watched it chew through entire mountain ranges, you'll understand that you don't want to get anywhere near it. We can only survive in here within pockets of stability. That's what you're standing in now. And that's what you're seeing mapped on the route planner. If we're going to find you a way out of the zone, you'll need to build a new antenna. Until then, you won't be able to detect stabilized routes beyond your immediate area. So, you've got to go hunting for parts, and that means taking a drive. Go on, pick a route. The arc device in your car will then show you where you need to go. Okay, newbie. I'll keep this simple. You don't want to overwhelm that little brain of yours. You'll need a few things to rebuild the antenna at the garage. First on the list is plasma. The woods are littered with plasma generators. Look for a research trailer or a spark tower. That's those antenna things zapping you when you get too close. Both are always accompanied by plasma generators. The arc device is picking up on some plasma generators nearby. Your headset has a built-in scanner. Use it on the plasma generator, and it'll figure out the tools you need. Looks like it's ripe for the picking. Can't get at it with your hands, though. An impact hammer will do the trick.
You out in the zone all on your own. They grow up so fast, don't they? And I'll be back at the helm. Been a long time, old gal. Didn't think we'd talk again after that whole Sasquatch incident.
Yes, I was hoping to go another decade without hearing your voice again. What did you finally talk Francis to death?
Hello to you too, Oppie. And no, I'm still here.
Driver, I bet you're dying to hear all about the remnants by now.
Can you not? I'm a little busy trying to keep them alive.
I'll keep to the basics, I promise. They deserve to know what they're getting into.
Fine. I'm giving you 60 seconds.
That is not nearly enough time to get...
55 seconds and counting.
Okay. The remnants, in short, they're old objects that do all sorts of weird things. They bind themselves to people, and you're the latest victim. You and the car are inseparable now, so get acquainted.
Thank you.
near one of the old guerrilla radio stations. That ought to be prime pickings for antenna parts. I've loaded its approximate location to your map. Look for an antenna tower up on a hill somewhere. time to get moving. The instability's ticking up by the second. But you can't get back the way you came. The instability makes all routes one way. And that's where my arc device comes into play. It'll get you back to the garage, but it needs to be charged first. And to do that, you'll need anchors. Take a look at the arc device display. It maps all anchors in the nearby area. Find an anchor and
feed it to the arc device to charge it. But don't you worry your pretty little head about how it works. We'll be out of here soon, so there's no reason to learn more about limb technology than you need to know. And ready. You'll use it to open a gateway back to the garage, but it will immediately collapse the stability around you. So only activate when you're absolutely ready to leave. You do not want to get caught in the storm that follows. Dive into it. Yes, it looks like hot death, but it's so much better than getting scrambled by the instability. you're alive. We're certain if the zone didn't get you, that gateway would.
Hmm.
Did I not mention that you're the first human I've sent through that thing? I mean, there've been rodents, but it's not like it's completely untested.
But anyway, it worked. So, you should have made it back with everything you collected out there. That's the beauty of the gateway. It's the only way to get back with all your marbles intact. Signals coming through loud and clear. Give it a moment to initialize. Make sure to empty your trunk before heading back out. You'll need the space.